In this video, we are going to learn the forms and characteristics of renewable energy sources. The learning outcome. After the end of this session, the learner will be able to explain various forms of renewable energy sources with their characteristics. Content. This video includes the classification of energy sources, significance of renewable energy sources, forms and characteristics of renewable energy sources. First, we will see the classification of energy sources. Energy sources are mainly classified into two categories. The first category is renewable energy sources. The examples of renewable energy sources are solar energy, wind energy, geothermal energy, tidal energy, hydro energy, and biomass. The second category is non-renewable energy sources. Examples of non-renewable energy sources are petroleum, nuclear, coal, and natural gas. Renewable energy sources such as water, solar, and geothermal, which can be replenished or renewed naturally over the time. Biofuel produced from food crops and other plants are replenished every growing season. So, biofuels are also classified into the renewable energy sources. Whereas, on other hand, non-renewable energy sources such as fossil fuels, nuclear material are removed or extracted from the earth crust and can be depleted. So, these sources have been the most used type of energy in the modern era. Now, we'll see the forms of renewable energy sources. The most popular renewable energy sources are solar energy, wind energy, hydro energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy, and biomass energy. Now we will see the solar energy. Solar energy is most abundant and freely available energy resources on the earth. The output of sun is 2.8 into 10 to 23 kilowatt, whereas the energy reaching on the surface of earth is 1.5 into 10 to 18 kilowatt per year. The efficiency of solar panel is low. Today, the most of solar panels provides an energy efficiency rating from 11% to 15%. That is, they convert the solar energy into electrical energy with 11 to 15% efficiency. The main part of solar power plant is solar photovoltaic system, that is PV system, which changes the sunlight into the electricity. The sunlight is caught by the solar panels and converted into usable electricity by the means of inverter. The electricity produced can then be used to power appliances at our homes directly, or that electricity can be stored in a battery for use of later when the sun is not shining. If we do not use or store the energy, the excess electricity can be directed back to the grids so that excess electricity can be used at another location. These are the few characteristics of solar energy. The sun energy is available abundantly and is inexhaustible. The solar energy can be produced easily. It can also be used for the storage for cloudy and rainy days. The figure shows typical layout of solar energy transmission. The first figure shows installed solar panels. When the solar panels are exposed to sunlight, they produce the electricity. That electricity is then transferred to the converter, which converts the DC form into AC form. The converter is shown in figure 2. That AC current then transferred to the meter, and then that can be used for household appliances. The excess electricity can also be transferred to the power grid as shown in figure. Now, I want you to take a pause and think on how to increase the efficiency of solar panels. Take your time and note down the points. The efficiency of solar panel is very low. Can we change the orientation of panels according to the position of sun to increase the efficiency? Or the change in material can cause the increase in efficiency? Just think on this. Okay, the next renewable energy source is wind energy. The wind energy is also byproduct of solar energy. Because of the energy receiving from the sun, the earth heats and cools unevenly, which results in the pressure difference at two locations, which causes the wind flow. A wind turbine is typically of 30-45% efficient, which can be increased up to 50% at the peak wind time. According to IRENA's latest data, that is International Renewable Energy Resource Agency's latest data, the production of wind electricity in 2016 accounted for the 16% of the total electricity generated by renewables. Wind turbines are classified into two general types. First is horizontal axis, second is vertical axis wind turbines. The first figure shows horizontal axis wind turbine. It is the most commonly used design configuration in wind turbines, when the rotating axis of the blades is parallel to the wind stream, the turbine is called horizontal axis wind turbine. The second diagram shows the vertical axis wind turbines. It is probably the oldest type of windmills, in which the axis of drive shaft is perpendicular to the ground as shown in figure. In Western countries, they have installed vertical turbines along the roads so that the wind coming from the moving vehicle rotates the blades of vertical axis wind turbine and they produce the electricity. This diagram shows the typical components of horizontal wind turbine. When the pressure due to air applied on the blades causes to rotate it, the rotary motion of shaft is transferred to the gearbox and generator, which produce the electricity. These are the some characteristics of wind energy. The first one is high average wind speed is required, that is cutoff and cut-on, both speed averages are high. The cut-on speed is the minimum speed of wind required to the rotate of blades of windmills, and cut-off speed is the highest speed at which the wind flow causes the cut-off of electricity. It is low cost energy, but it also required high initial investment. The third most commonly used renewable energy sources is hydro energy. Hydropower is energy derived from the flowing water. The basic principle of hydropower is using water to drive turbines. The hydro energy power share of 60-70% of total world electricity generation and 50-60% of the electricity generated by renewables. It is among the most cost effective means of generating electricity and is often preferred method where available. For example, in Norway, 99% of the electricity comes from hydropower. Hydropower plants consist of two basic configurations, with dams and reservoirs or without. The currently installed capacity of hydropower energy in India has around 45,700 megawatt. The figure shows the creation of head by constructing a dam, where the potential energy of stored water is used to run the turbines, with which the help of generator produce the electricity. These are the some characteristics of hydro energy. It require high investment, but it is also low cost energy resources. That is, the cost of per unit electricity generated is very low. It is easy to control and can be used for storage. These are the references. Thank you.